Hello, weather enthusiasts. This is Rob Does Everything, and we are back with a severe weather update. Here we can see I've got the SPC pulled up. We have an enhanced risk of severe weather for tomorrow, Friday. We've got a 10% hatched area for significant or strong tornadoes over a large portion of the Midwest, Dixie Alley. We've got a little bit of the Ozarks in here. Things could get pretty interesting. You know that a strong tornado is possible overnight, and I think that we could get multiple strong tornadoes, noting that recent model runs have been showing storms being a little bit more supercellular than linear, and if not, it's a broken linear line, which can still cause quite a bit more tornadoes than just a normal linear line would. So we're going to go ahead and look at some of the models here, and this is the reason we're getting this. We can see this massive trough dipping down. What people don't, for people who don't know, a trough, this is sort of like the jet streak. But basically what it is we have winds moving southeast here. These wind barbs, what they do is they note direction. So we're looking at southeast winds that tilt east and then tilt more northeast as they go through. So we call this a trough. And anytime you get a trough like this, you're gonna have severe weather on the eastern side of a trough ejection. We can see this is more of a positive, neutrally tilted trough, which kind of lessens the severe weather chances, but still you're gonna have a chance for probably an outbreak, even with a more neutrally tilted trough or a more positively tilted trough. So we're gonna go ahead and get into some things here, like storm relative helicity. We're gonna go ahead and take a peek up close and in personal with some of these models. You can see here we're gonna skip all the way through up until storms aren't gonna be initiating until late. So we're looking at storms initiating about 4Z, which is nearing midnight here. And you can see this is strong storm relative helicity. So what this is as Ryan Hall, y'all, anybody who watches him would note, this is almost like tornado juice, right? Basically, this is the twist and the turn in the atmosphere, the helicity that rotates in the atmosphere as storms go up. So we can go ahead and look at a sounding here. We've got nearly 1,000 Cape, shear at 50, 53 in the upper levels. And this causes storm relative helicities of over 400. Anytime you have storm relative helicities in the multiple hundreds, 300, 400, you're going to have tornadoes, a potential for strong tornadoes, as a matter of fact. Now over here, this is the hodograph. This hodograph, basically what it is we are taking a top-down look at the wind as it increases with height in the atmosphere. So 0, the lowest levels in the atmosphere, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So as we go up in the atmosphere, we can see the winds turn, the winds rotate, and we actually kind of get like a little bit of a loop-de-loop here. So that's why we have possible hazard of tornadoes. We're going to have a very strong warm sector from all of this Gulf moisture that's going to be pulled up here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the surface dew points, because really we need some 60 degree dew points, and this storm system should be just cranking dew points. You can watch that warm sector just absolutely explode right there around 12Z, 13Z, just boom. It floods all the way up into Illinois. In December, we've got 60, 50 degree dew points, and then it almost pushes up 60 degree dew points nearly to the Michigan border, the Michigan-Indiana border, the Ohio border here. Anytime you have dew points this strong, this far north, you're gonna have severe weather. Now, I've been focusing more on the northern mode, and I know this because I live up here in Ohio, and I will probably be chasing this northern mode. However, what looks probably more intriguing is the storms firing in this southern mode. We have much higher Cape down here. Maybe not better in terms of our wind dynamics, our shear, our storm relative helicity, but storms are going to have more energy to feed off of farther south down here. But either way, storms are going to fire up here. Anytime you get 60s, mid-60s dew points firing all the way this far north, this time of year, you're going to have severe weather. We can see that those dew points push all the way into southern Ohio. Southern Ohio will have probably a couple tornado warnings if things do pan out the way that we expect them to pan out. But we can look here. The problem with this setup, not only with chasing, but also with saving lives, is that this will be a very nighttime, nocturnal event. We'll go ahead and look at the convective allowing model here on the HER. We'll go ahead and run it out. We can see we get some bubble, you know, just some warm sector thunderstorms here. Maybe we start to get some convection going up in Illinois, Indiana. We can see that's not severe, ultimately. That's not severe in nature. Now, what is severe is what's to come whenever storms actually start to fire along some of these prefrontal confluences, along that jet stream, the lower level jet that is just piping down there. We can see this one storm that gets convected down here in, I believe that was Mississippi. Let's go ahead and run out a little far. Mississippi or Tennessee. This would be just about perfect. We've got Cape in the thousands. We've got storm relative helicity in the 300s. And we've got a nice loop on the hodograph. That's a really nice loop. We can see storms backed from, or wind is backed from the south. And then with height turns to a more southwesterly direction, so west-southwest direction. And as we progress through here, we can see storms start to fire in Illinois, Indiana, a couple in western Ohio. These will not be in severe in nature. Likely most of these will not be severe in nature until we get to just about right here. Now we're looking at storms that are going to be severe. Looking at the possibility of some tornadoes, we can see at this point the shear is kind of struggling right about here, but we think about 2 o'clock to 10 o'clock in the morning, if you live in eastern Indiana, southwestern Ohio, central Ohio, this whole range right here. I live in Ohio, just to give some context. I live in Ohio, that's why I'm talking more about the Midwest side of the setup. I'm going to cover the entire thing, but I'm mainly focusing on this because I feel like a lot of people disregard the northern mode because of how favorable some of the conditions are down south. We'll go ahead and take a sounding here, and it's a tornado sounding. We can see winds again backed from the south, turning more westerly through height, nearly 1,000 Cape here, storm relative helicity right at 300, and a looping hodograph. You're going to have tornadoes. You're going to have multiple tornadoes, as a matter of fact. We're probably going to see potentially a tornado outbreak. It will be a severe weather outbreak and potentially a tornado outbreak if things really stack up in the correct manner. Now we can see a lot of these storms push through. This is where the front is pushing through, I believe, behind the storms, causing some of these to fire up here. And even these ones, midday, this one, I actually did not expect this one to have a tornado sounding, but it does. Very low cape, but still storms can fire off of fronts with limited cape. We can see again winds backed from the south, turning more west height. This is more of a long looping hodograph, but you can still have tornadoes with them. We're gonna go ahead and run this out even farther, and you can see that the threat starts to die off more midday through Saturday. And it starts to become more of a southern mode. Georgia, the Carolinas, places like that. We're going to go ahead and run this back. Talk about really where I think most of the danger is going to come with the system. And I think most of the danger with this system is going to come probably in the southern moat, quite honestly. I mean, we've got 1,000 cape here, more than enough cape. SRH nearly 250 and another looping. And I know I'm kind of doing a little bit of rambling here, and I think I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up soon just to get to the point. But we've got all the ingredients here across a large sector. This is why we have this 10% hatched risk. And I think that this risk could be upgraded whenever we get a little bit closer. Tomorrow, we actually get some real close models. We start to get a more complete picture of how the trough is going to eject, the timing, because the problem is some of the models don't convect storms until after sundown, even near midnight. And that's a problem because we are limiting some of our ability to chase, to report, to assist. And really, this is something that people have to keep an eye on. I mean, I would have a weather radio ready. Kentucky, you're looking at it. Kentucky at like 4 o'clock in the morning, early hours. Southern Ohio, all the way down through Tennessee, northern Mississippi's gonna have it. Missouri's where storms are gonna probably be initially firing here. We have a very large, this is more of a mega trough ejection. So what happens whenever you have these mega troughs is they are so large that they displace such a large low-level jet. That's why you have such a large warm sector feeding in, is because you have these winds just pulling up moisture right across here, and it just outspreads this whole area. We're gonna go ahead and just one more look at 2 points again, just to get an idea. Yeah, you can see we get the start right here, Friday, early in the morning. We get dew points just barely starting to reach Illinois. Now we're getting into the afternoon, into the evening hours, and we start to see this warm sector boom, boom, just start to fly north. My camera has just died, but yeah, we're looking at 60s dew points. And again, the GFS is kind of I think just under predicting the dew points here. I'm not sure exactly why and the northward extent of the dew points. But either way, I mean, it still pushes the dew points all the way right up to the lake in Ohio. That is absolutely insane. Anytime you see something like this, you've got dews of 60 here and then dew points of 20s back here. This is called a dry line. So what this is, anytime you see this, you're going to have severe weather in this large swath, right? Places like Missouri, Arkansas, East Texas, Louisiana, Mississippi, probably Northern Alabama, Tennessee, Kentucky, what did I say? Illinois, Indiana, Ohio. All of these states in here that are just being absolutely covered by this entire warm sector, you're under the gun for severe weather. And quite frankly, there can be tornadoes across the entirety of this warm sector, even up into central Illinois, central Indiana, even into Ohio coming in early morning on Saturday. These conditions are ripe for severe weather. So we're gonna go ahead and wrap it up there. I'll probably do an update tomorrow, depending on how the models look, how things look, if I'm gonna chase, really anything like that. So, thank you guys so much for checking in and watching, and I hope you all have a wonderful day and never stop chasing. Be Timmer. Goodbye, guys.